used to be that managers could read a book, and the contents of that book would serve them well for decades. Well, not anymore. Did you know it takes anywhere from 1 to 2 years for traditional book publishers to publish a manuscript that may have taken as long as 3 years to write? That's the reason you see so many e-books in the market today. They're quick and they're easy to publish, and the whole thing can be done in about a weekend. The workplace is changing, the people in it are changing, the values and expectations are changing, how you address on-the-job performance is changing, how you attract and recruit and hire and manage people, even how you react to change is changing, but biggest of all, communication is changing. It's all changed. This isn't your father's workplace anymore. Everything that was once cast in stone is up for discussion now because everything is changing. But are you? For the past few years, generational experts have been making money hand over fist, delivering learning sessions to organizations because this whole new Gen Y thing took them by surprise. Really? By surprise? The kids you raise and then turn them loose into the marketplace took you by surprise. It was no surprise. It's because there's a cultural philosophy in your workplace that says, once you become a manager, we're going to stop training you. And if we do train you, it'll be the same way we've always done it. Until, of course, something surprises us. And then we're going to react to it. See, even the whole leadership movement in the workplace today is creating problems. Companies are sending mediocre managers to leadership school and hoping that it makes a better workplace. But it doesn't. In fact, the most recent numbers say that over 70% of your workforce is not fully engaged in their work. That means that less than 3 out of 10 of your own employees are fully engaged. Less than 3 out of 10. Leadership development of your managers isn't working. And the more you insist that your managers become leaders, the further away from relevance they get from your employees. See, your employees don't want their managers to be visionaries. Your people want skills development. They want someone to coach them to a better performance, something tangible that they can use to get ahead. Look, you're never going to get people to engage in their work by expecting them to just blindly follow their managers. Managers have to earn respect by rolling up their shirt sleeves and coaching each employee's performance to better results. And truthfully, it's nearly impossible to feel disengaged from a job that you really enjoy and something you're exceptional at. So help your people become exceptional, even if they fight you at first. No one ever really hates being the best at what they do and the recognition that comes with it. They enjoy it. They bask in it. Once they're really good at their job, engagement follows. So here's how you make it work. Job one today and every day is this. Find a way to coach each employee to become exceptional at least one thing. And not the same thing for each employee either, because that just makes them all mediocre. But one small thing for each employee. Give each one an edge in one particular thing and then recognize them for how well they're doing at that one thing. Keep on recognizing them by asking them to mentor your other employees at their one thing. And once you've got employees mentoring other employees and everyone is mentoring someone else, you have an engaged workforce. And your job as manager is to manage the mentorship program. You see, you as a manager work for them. They don't work for you. That's one of the new changes in the workplace, by the way, just in case you didn't get the memo. I'm Kevin Burns. Now go make it work.